give an example of how anatomy trains can be put into practice. If we look at this young lady here and we see she is really upright, very strong, very balanced in her body, especially if we compare left and right. And if I just get you to turn to face me. However, if we look from the side, we see the comparison between the front and the back. Most of these things with posture and function take a look at what is too short. So if we look, we can see that she has very good tone in her abdomen, such tone in the upper two parts of her six-pack that she is pulling her ribcage down. The idea of the rectus abdominis, according to our ideas, would be that it should pull up on the pubic bone, not pull down on the ribcage. Before we do this, is just take a deep breath. Respirate. Mm-hmm. So you watch the motion of the ribcage when she is doing that. So it's not necessarily on the ribcage that we need to work. You'll see. Okay, take another breath. Good. Okay, so starting with the upper part of the abdominal fascia and the rectus abdominis, we are going along the sixth and fifth rib. I'm using six fingers to move the whole sheet, the whole fascial plane of the front of the body. So what muscle am I on? Well, I was on rectus abdominis. Take a nice deep in-breath as I work. Yep. And out. I have to be working in the fascial planes enough to create shear between the fascial planes. And then we carry this up the sternum a little bit. You have the sternal fascia on the sternum. And then you have the pectoral fascia going out. It's all one fascia. It's all part of the fascia profundis. So try to put your cheek on the table. That's it. So here, osteopaths, we're going right up to the asterion, which is the suture where the occiput, temporal, and parietal bones meet. You can usually find it right here as a dimple where the finger fits. So this is a great place to release. Even a relaxed sternocleidomastoid is exerting 20 grams of pressure on this through the fascia across the mastoid process to the asterion. So, if we are going to do our cranial work with 5 grams of pressure and expect it to stay, we have to ease the 20 grams of tension that the sternocleidomastoid is putting. So, the retinaculum is often depicted in the anatomy books as just a strap around the 6 or 7 tendons that go under this part of the crural fascia. When she comes up, do you see the fold in the skin in front of my fingers? This is indicative that the fascia is tied down, so it's worthwhile, even though it burns her a little bit, it's worthwhile for me to go through here and open this, because if you do it again now, mm-hmm. can you feel it's easier?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, good. So that we use the information that we get from the retinacula to tune our posture in action during athletic activity and rehab activity. Mm-hmm. This is a good area to free up and wake up, both because of its biomechanical and because of its proprioception. Anyway, that's enough.